people get scared.
Right.
Yeah, even when they have to get conceived, they stop exercising. I'm like, so can you talk about...
You know, these are myth busters. I mean, like, that we need to... I mean, we have to break these myths. This is a myth and we need to bust this myth. It's... I mean, everybody should be exercising, women especially when you want to conceive, because it's very important. As you are a doctor, you know how hip alignment, your pelvis alignment, so many miscarriages actually happen because they do not exercise, you know. And I have seen a lot of apprehension, but according to yoga, when we do yoga, I always start off after 3 months. So when at the time, from the time that they know that they have conceived until 3 months or until implantation, we always advise anybody who's doing it to, if you're a beginner, for light exercise. If you have been practicing yoga or exercising every day, we also do advise light exercise during those first 3 months. But after implantation, it's very important to improve and strengthen that pelvic flow, you know, to hold your baby in. Also pre, just to conceive, it's important to have your hip alignment correct. Something as small as wearing high heel shoes constantly can misalign your hips, and which in turn affects your lymphatic system or the alignment of your uterus to even conceive. So all these things are very important, I feel, which women today don't know. They feel, you know, if we exercise, there might be something wrong, or when I am pregnant and I over-exercise, there will be something, or, you know, there has been a miscarriage just because of exercise. Yes, it does happen sometimes because of exercise, but that's incorrect exercise. But if you are exercising your uterus, your pelvic floor, the rest of your body correctly, it's very important to host a very healthy environment for your child. Coming to healthy environment, healthy mind, you cannot be stressed out. I mean, stressed is such a long, I mean, it's such a word that has been used so often. People don't realize, especially in a woman, it's so important to have your hormonal balance. And stress is one of the triggers that actually causes all that confusion inside your body, you know. So exercise is one of the best things for anti-stress, anti-anxiety, and the different kind of external as well as internal issues that one is facing. So yes, there are specific target asanas in yoga, as well as we do in lamas, to open up your hips, to keep your pelvic floor healthy. Use your mola band, like use your kegel muscles to strengthen it. Not only pre is when you have to create an environment for to get a healthy baby in. Secondly, when the baby is inside your uterus, to make a healthier environment. Thirdly, when the baby, you've delivered the baby, to understand that your body has gone through 9 months of change. So lots of women think, agar ye karenge, nahi to agar, I will walk more than 1 hour, kuch hone wala. Aisa kuch nahi hota hai. That's wrong. Everyone should exercise. Exercise in any way. Yoga, of course, I love, because I feel it's the most healthiest way to keep fit while being pregnant, because there is so much research gone, there is so much research done in each particular asana or posture. But any kind of exercise, doing a correct exercise is always good, any form. Awesome. Yes.